Alright, welcome to the second episode of my Promised Land series. I'm still using the Biomes of Plenty mod in this world, which the seed is Promised Land. I think I'm under a desert biome right now. I started a little bit of caving. I actually had some footage recorded before I hit the record button right now, but for some reason it wasn't registering my microphone. So it was like 45 minutes of footage where I wasn't talking. It wasn't anything too terribly exciting that I lost, fortunately. The most exciting thing that happened was I walked across the volcano and found a cave spider spawner down here, eventually got into a desert biome, and that was pretty much about it for the excitement factor, so you guys really didn't miss anything. I don't know what I was trying to hit with that baked potato. Now, I have been finding some of the new ores. There are rubies in deserts, apparently. So it's going to get us a little bit closer to our goal of getting to the Promised Land, because you have to have all the gems. Right now I'm just gathering some resources, nothing too terribly exciting. Amazingly, I haven't found any dungeons yet, and I've actually been down here for a while now, so I don't get what's up with that. For me, that is highly unusual. I don't know if there's anything that way. Hopefully I can find some of the rubies here so I can show you what they look like in ore form. Now if you notice my smooth lighting is off, that's because it helps my frame rate immensely. If I don't turn smooth lighting off, I'm getting a whopping 8 frames per second when I record. If I do turn it off, it goes up to about 13, which isn't great by any means, but it's a lot more doable. Because at 8 frames per second, it's just plain hard to play. It's just a real pain in the butt. Now, I am still going to be doing the Nightmare series. That's definitely not going anywhere. I'm just trying to work out where to go with it next. Because, you know, it is called Isle of Spiders' Minecraft Nightmare, and I want there to actually be some nightmare in the series instead of, you know, just regular gameplay all the time. I mean, it's good to have a nice, quiet episode. What the heck? Did that zombie just, like, reproduce? I've got no torch. Oh, yes, I do. I made myself about 2 stacks, and these are actually the rubies right here. So I'm hoping we find them in ore form. You are wearing armor, obviously. What a pain. Oh, he dropped some armor for me. Lucky. But no, I'm definitely not done with the Nightmare series by any shot. I still plan on doing that for a while to come now. And in other news, I will be updating the server pretty soon, too. They're finally about to fix the vampire plugin, which I had to take off about a month ago. I know some people were pretty disappointed about that, but it was extremely buggy and almost to the point where it was unplayable. And it just wasn't fun to play anymore. There's a lot of bugs with the hunger bar, which I noticed when I was testing it. So I do test the plugins that I put on the server. Werewolf 1 is still on right now. Hopefully the vampire 1 will be back on within a week here, because I know they're waiting to approve the file from the bucket team. And when they do that, I can download it, and hopefully it's fairly bug-free. Oh, there's some ruby ore. And hopefully it's fairly bug-free now. And I know the server's been kind of quiet lately, just because there haven't been a lot of people on. And I think what's happening with that is people don't want to get on the server by themselves. So what they're doing is they're refreshing their screen over and over to see if anybody else is on. And that's pretty much mostly all that's been happening on the servers. People are refreshing their screens and seeing nobody on and not getting on. But the thing is, a lot of the time, 2 or 3 people are refreshing their screens at the same time waiting for someone to get on, and nobody's actually getting on the server. So it's kind of like a big... If you've ever watched like nature documentaries or anything, it's kind of like a big group of penguins waiting for one to fall in the water before the rest go in the water. Nobody wants to be the first one. So that's pretty much what's been happening on the server lately. Is nobody's getting on because they're waiting for other people to get on, and they don't know that there's other people waiting for other people to get on, so it's kind of not working out right now. So if you're on the server and you don't see anybody's on, you know, try to get on for a little while and maybe somebody will get on and join you. Because it is happening quite frequently that more than one person's refreshing their screen at the same time and seeing nobody on. I don't know if you get what I'm saying or not. It's kind of hard to put into words. Or if somebody is getting on right now, they're staying on for 5 seconds and then getting off because nobody else is on. And if you want somebody to get on and join you, you might want to try to stay on for more than 5 seconds. I'm just saying, it's just a suggestion. I'm hearing a lot of zombies. Oh, there's some more rubies down there. I think you can make blocks out of these too, which will look really cool. Yeah, there are several gems. I'm hearing a lot of zombies. Could be a group spawn. Or it could be something that starts with D, which would be my luck. I really should make a new sword here. Let's pull her up right here, because if there are zombies up here, I don't want them coming over to me. Yep, there they are. Looks like it's probably just a group spawn. Let's get rid of these guys. I think for the gems to make the wand, you have to get like a sapphire, and I think there's amethyst that you can get. Something called tanzanite. There's all kinds of really strange gemstones that you can pick up. It depends on the biome. So it looks like deserts have rubies. I know hilly biomes have certain ores too. Let's go ahead and pick these up here. So I'm going to have to explore a lot of different biomes to find all the gems. Either that or find a lot of dungeon chests. This mineshaft has been rather devoid of chests. I have not seen a single chest yet. I've only seen one cave spider spawner, which for me is highly unusual. It's very quiet. Hi, bats. I think I'm still in the desert biome. I'm starting to run out of food, so I had about 16 baked potatoes when I set out here to explore. I hate the... Oh, I spoke too soon. There's another cave spider spawner. I gotta go take care of it. Yep, there's lots of web. Crud. It's called use the mineshaft holes to your advantage. Get rid of that. There's a zombie stuck in there, too. That actually went pretty well. I caught it in time. Did I bring shears with me? Yes, I did. Should have used those in the first place. Sometimes I have good luck finding chests behind these things, but it doesn't look like I'm going to find one. Just a lava pool. I haven't found any diamonds yet, which is unfortunate, because I could really use the obsidian. Alright, that's done. This is a very large mineshaft. Nope, nothing in that. Oh, looks like I found another orb. According to my achievements, I just walked into a tundra. So this is a brand new biome, so this must be what you find in tundras, whatever those are. Let me see what those are. Those are tanzanites, which I'm not a mineral expert, so I'm not even sure what that is, but I guess it's a little bit closer. This is a huge mineshaft. I know I heard another cave spider spawner back that way. Which is going to stink. I do have some iron cooking. That's a sapphire. So the gems actually won't be the really difficult part of this. It's going to be killing the bosses. That's going to be the difficult part. So much prep work involved in both of those. Oh, skeleton. Duck and cover. So at least we got three of the gems going now. I don't know where that goes. I'll have to explore this a little bit later. Back here I was hearing multiplying spiders. So I gotta be really careful. Right around here, yep. When you hear multiplying spiders in a mineshaft, it's about 95% chance of being a cave spider spawner. If you're lucky, it'll just be a spider dungeon. If you're lucky. So that I'm gonna come back to a bit later. Yeah, I haven't even explored up there yet. Wow. My shaft just doesn't stop. So let me head back. Oh, my iron was cooking right over here. Gotta do some inventory management. This stuff's almost done, it looks like. I'm gonna have well over a stack. I should probably cook up the gold, too. Just, like, merge it with my gold bars in my inventory. Alright, this is actually two mineshafts on top of each other. I'm really good at finding these things. That's the second boss room I found in this mess. I hear slime. I think I'm going to explore this for as long as my food supplies will allow. Which, being as I have only about 3 more baked potatoes, isn't going to be much longer, unfortunately. I'll have to go up and resupply here in a bit. Wow, this just goes on forever. Let's get rid of that. Alright, I've surfaced in the middle of the night. I have no idea what kind of biome this is. I think this might be the tundra biome I'm standing over right now with all these little rocky outcroppings and these little shrubs. That's a glacier right there. I don't think it's the same when I walked over, though. This is the desert that I know I did come over, so I'm going to have to follow it that way when I'm done. And there's a zombie sinking in quicksand over there. Which reminds me, I got something to show you guys when I get back to base here. Oh, I think it's just like one block high quicksand. He's just plain stuck. So, that's kind of funny. But yeah, I have all these zombies waiting for me. But when it's morning, they're going to be in a world of hurt. So I just pillared up for the night because with this new zombie swarming behavior, it's impossible to just walk at night like I used to. I used to have pretty much no problems traveling at night as long as I had armor on. And they're dying on those tiny cactuses over there. I'll have to pick one of those and take those home with me. And to my garden, which I haven't even started yet. I think I'll come right back when it's morning and I'm able to get down off this pillar. Well, if this is the desert I came over, I certainly miss this desert temple sitting out here. So let's go check it out real quick on the way home. I think I'm completely out of food, unfortunately, so I'm going to have to take a little bit of fall damage there. Let's go ahead and make sure this is safe for the time being. Sometimes mobs do like to hide in these little things out here. This is one of those half-buried ones. Yep. So let's go see what's in the chest here. Probably some more of the gemstones that I need. Let's get rid of that. Alright, I'll take the gold bars and the bones. It's good for gardening. I would like to get some emeralds, too, if they have any. I do need the saddles. Let's get rid of the rotten flesh. I don't need that. I do have horses that I can stand to tame. Why do they add rotten flesh in here? That is disgusting. Alright, wasn't terrible loot. Wasn't the greatest loot in the world, either, so go ahead and get out of here. That way if I walk in here again, I'll see this piece of cobblestone and know that I already did this. No, I can never find the way out of here. Oh, I guess I'm coming up this way. Alright, there's the volcano biome. So I'm not that far from home. I am, however, completely out of food.
Volcano!
Home came along pretty quickly here. I really seriously need to eat. And this here is my quicksand welcome mat. I recorded it during that lost footage where it wasn't recording my voice, but that's what it is right there. It pretty much, this is like one block layer, thick layer of quicksand right here, and I think it's turning nighttime right now. I don't know if I have any food stored. And I do, actually. So go ahead and eat real quick before I starve to death. That would not be a good thing. Oh, maybe it's not turning night. Carrots are not very filling. But when it turns night here, I'll show you what this quicksand welcome mat does. And I put a little overhang over Fort Chunk Error here, because zombies were falling off the top of the ledge here and landing on my head. And it wasn't too pretty. I think before I collect anything, I should go ahead and stash this stuff in chests here. Alright, I'll go ahead and show you now what my quicksand welcome mat does. You've probably guessed that already, but here comes a zombie. So, this is just a little platform for me, and I knock it out at night. That way, this is completely impassable to mobs. I hear a couple coming at me, but they're not going to be able to reach me, so I'm perfectly safe standing right here unless a skeleton comes along. It's caught a couple of those, but primarily it's been catching the zombies. You know, because of their swarming behavior, it doesn't catch spiders yet. I would need to rig it in order to catch spiders. The zombies have lost sight of me. Over here, stupid. Oh, but I don't want to catch that. Where'd that creeper go? I don't know. Ah, here we go. This is what happens when mobs try to cross my quicksand welcome mat. Bye, zombie. And I made a little room down here. Here comes the zombie. He's going to start taking suffocation damage, and he will suffocate to death before he gets down here, but if I want the experience, I guess it'd be good if I had a working sword on my bar. I can actually take a swing or two and kill them and get the XP that way pretty safely. So this is just going to be my little collection room right here. I'll have to find a way to get the other mobs to sink through, but right now it's going to be primarily zombies. So I'll work out something better. Since I hit that zombie, I'm going to have 20 more coming up to my door here. Wow, they're idiots. Oh, this is bad as villagers. Oh, you gotta wait your turn to go down and suffocate, zombie. Don't you know that? You gotta be polite. It's gonna be quite noisy here, but they won't be beating my door down, which is good. It's gonna be primarily rotten flesh come down here as drops, though, till I work out something better. But anyway, that's my collection room right here. I am going to be putting in a storeroom off camera, so I'm probably going to be digging down here. Because I don't want my storeroom to be down here, it's going to be way too distracting at night and having all these mob legs coming down. Up I come, skeleton. Wish I could find a way to catch more of them. Here comes a zombie. They just can't wait their turns, can they? If I jump up here, I do briefly get stuck, so. Yay, rotten flesh. Whoa, there's a creeper. Hi, stupid creeper. Oh, they're with the welcome mat. I have a lot more quicksand, though. Where did you come from? They're not gonna get up there now. Haha. Alright, that's repaired. I don't want to be catching any more creepers this close to the door, so this is gonna definitely need some tweaking. But I think the general idea is good. And Spider, how'd you get in there? Sorry, Spider. So I might put the welcome mat a little bit farther out from the door. Make some kind of little bridge that I can retract at night quite easily. And I think I'll be pretty good after that. Hey, skeleton. They're much better, easier to catch than the zombies are. There we go. Give me a bow. Let's just see some legs coming down. There's your legs. Alright, give me that stuff. There we go. I think I'm going to call this an episode for today. Now that I've shut off my quicksand welcome mat. I'm not positive what I'm going to do next time. I'm probably going to be tweaking this out here. I might tame the horses in the next episode. And I do still need to record another episode of Minecraft Nightmare this week, hopefully. Next weekend will be the absolute latest that I recorded, but I'm definitely going to be doing that some more, so I will see you next time.